Hello, fellow. My name is James Owusu-Apia, and I believe in innovation and doing things differently. This video has been prepared for you to guide you through some well-known concepts that will aid your studies and preparations towards exam. Due to COVID, we cannot meet in person to discuss, so I hope this video finds you well and helps you achieve excellence. Thank you.
Now, because all our registers have been configured to be, they are already Ryzen Edge. So it could be, so we could just make the micro instruction counter a falling edge. Then we'll be able to achieve that effect. You see, because we want to set up the instruction at one, you know, So that is the style we'll use, right? We could do it all the way around, but here we just, because all the registers are already Ryzen Edge, so there's no need of kind of changing it again. So we'll make the micro instruction counter to be falling edge triggered. So that is one way, right? If we don't want to do it that way too, we could just negate the clock that is coming into the world. We could still maintain as Ryzen Edge, right? But what we'll do is that we will negate the clock signal. So let me get a not gate here, and then I will negate this clock signal, which will still achieve the same effect. We achieve the same effect of making it falling edge. So by doing it this way, right, we'll get a scene. It's the same as if, so this would be like as if it's a falling edge. It will not become a falling edge, something like that, on our new clock, something. So we can configure it as a falling edge and then just connect the line directly, or we'll just negate the clock and do it the other way around, you see. So by negating this main clock and then passing it into this micro instruction counter, right, we're able to achieve that sort of effect. See those two opposite clock that are synchronized, something like that. So I hope you understand. I mean, there was a lot, but I want to be done quickly. So so this is it. Yeah, so this just understand its opposite. So maybe, so what we have now set up, right? What we have set up there is that we are going to set up our instructions on a falling edge of the clock, and then on a rising edge of the clock, they can be what executed. Because you see, all our memory element, right? We also need this particular control signal for the micro instruction counter. But it seems that they didn't connect, and I didn't send it, so that's why I just kind of pull this wire here. And as I said, you will need, I mean, once you are in need of more output, or you have to control more signals, and you have to increase the number of outputs, right? So now our outputs, they are now at about 13 outputs. So you see, that's a lot of outputs right there to work with. But in any case, all our output pins set up, and our inputs, they are all set. So and then we are also set the clock, and we have decided that at the falling edge of the clock, we will kind of set up instructions, or we'll set up signals, right? And then so that they can be executed on the rising edge of the clock. So that is how that's the timing that we'll be using. So let me go back, and let's go back to the truth table. So let's go back to the truth table here. Now, if you see the truth table, so we are going to construct a truth table, and then we are putting it in this form. So basically, you have the inputs here, and then this column separate the inputs from the outputs, as you can see, right? And so permit me for now to use a comma. It's just already not, but it's just permitting to use it for now. You see why later. But it does not change the fact that this is a truth table that we're going to fill in, right? It's a truth table. And I enable C syntax highlighting, because we want to be commenting as we are kind of filling the table. That's how it's going to work, right? So let's see the inputs, right? Where are these inputs coming from, right? I have cell 0, cell 1. So the CIR, the other bits from what? So, don't know why I didn't open that one. Okay, the CIR, right? The other bit, these are the bits from our the current instruction register. Not this. So the CIR, so you see here. So CIR 0 is the first order lower bit from the current instruction register, CIR 1, and the same thing just imply for the rest. So MIC 0, MIC 1, and then up to, you know, so these, let me come back to it again. So CIR 0, CIR 1, So this that from the current instruction register. And then MRC will know. Okay, sorry. Let me delete this one from there. MRC stop at MRC 2. And then the same thing apply for the FBR. Yeah. So, and the same thing also apply for Democratic. Let's see. Okay, let me check back. Okay. So this is a 3-bit. So this is also 3-bit. So yeah, it's fine. I'm right. So yeah. So the CR0, CR1, CR2, these are what, and CR3, these are the bits from the instruction register. So the 4-bits from the instruction register, these are then here on that other input, as you can see them here. They are all input. So guys, and the next set of 3-bits, they are the micro instruction counter. They are from that register. And then this FBR, they are from the feedback. These are the feedback inputs. And then, so we just wrote them here as it's there. And then let's see the output side, right? We have, so these things that they are the names that we give to all the signals. So you see the zero, yeah, this zero here corresponds to the zero here, right? And then we trace this line, but you see this is the name that we give to this signal. DMIIU, or something, that is the data memory address register input enable. So all these signals have name, and that is just what we have here. So we just kind of, you know, transfer this in the whole thing here. The inputs, the outputs on this table, on the truth table here to fill it in. And since, so let me add the new signal that I added just now, the clear, which is this is the clear signal from the micro instruction counter. So I will label it so that we can have, so let me label this signal. So I'll just put a labeling right here. Just on this yourself, cry. So this is the CLR, so I'll call it CR or CLR clear or something like that. So that's it. We can, so it's just a little bit of that signal, right? Sorry. Okay, so and let me go back to it. Yeah, there's it. So clear, right? So I just call it CLR. So micro instruction counter, the clear signal from there. So this is what we have. This is what we have. So let me add a new signal there. So this signal will be called, let me move the comma and then add the MICCLR clear, right? Then bring the comma back. So the table is now is set. The table is set. As you can see, the table is set. So let's, now we're going to kind of fill in this table, right? We'll try and fill in the table. As you can see here, all the inputs are there and all the outputs are on this side, right? After the column, other than these are the outputs of our this thing. And these are all the inputs, right? Now later on, if you need further inputs, right? I mean, further outputs, you can add more outputs to them, right? Then if you need, but now you will not, for the system I've already designed in mind, you wouldn't need more inputs. These inputs are fine. All right, so with that out of the way, let's see how we are going to fill in this table, right? You see here, this is it's going to be a lot of work to fill in the table, but hopefully, we have tools that will make our life easier. So let's just get started with it. So first of all, once you have established the fact that we set up instructions on a falling edge and then have them executed on a rising edge, with that fact established, so we can now start programming our CPU, our control units. So why not? Let's get started with the first instruction.